approves it, will you sign the RH bill without any revision?
If Congress?
Yes.
As I've said, I will exercise my presidential authority to protect the national interest of the Philippine people.
But the Congress...
If in my personal view, based on a special study, that there are mistakes committed, that there are only some foreign vested interest groups which are being benefited because of some possible reports that I received, you know, I have to stand up for the national interest of the country. If I can see that the national interest of the Philippine people is being sacrificed, I will not hesitate to exercise the presidential power.
What are your short-term and long-term solutions to address poverty in the country?
Poverty? The short solution to me is demolish and destroy the built-in mechanism of corruption in the government system. Because I believe the evils of corruption are directly related to the evils of poverty. I was informed sometime in 2003-2004 that the World Bank confirmed that 40% of the total budget of the Philippine government goes to corruption. Today, lately, I was informed by a good columnist, Sito Beltran, and confirmed reportedly by the World Bank that it's no longer 40%, but it is 50% now of the total budget goes to corruption. And I suddenly remember the reason why I was convinced last 2004 to run for president, when I, in the midst of my refusal to leave my comfort zone, someone handed me an article, a portion of that article written by a certain Dr. James Walker, a noted economist from Scotland who has been specializing on the economies of Asian region. He said, I have not seen or known a country in this world like the Philippines that used to be number one in Asia. Until 1943, even richer than Japan. But 50 years after, in socialist time, the Philippines had fallen down to the bottom, overtaken by neighboring countries, because the Philippines had undergone incredible deterioration due to shocking unabated political corruption. So the immediate solution to me in fighting poverty is to stop the evils of corruption and support the cry of the youth for zero corruption. We are dreaming in Bangon Pilipinas, corruption-free Philippines. And then rechannel the bulk of the money, the budget, to massive economic development programs and projects. We have what we call strategic economic growth centers to be established in every region and, if possible, as allowed by the budget, in every province. What does it mean? We will conduct a special study on the weaknesses and strengths of every province and eventually every region, and then support a well-guided economic strategy to accelerate and fast-track the economic development and growth on those regions or provinces, thereby providing better employment to our people, thus encouraging OFWs to come home and enjoy the love and fellowship of their respective family, and at the same time having what I call a dignified livelihood.
Sir, question regarding to bills aggravating corruption in the first. Four presidents already vowed to stamp out corruption. going to announce also yung kanilang platform, Graphing Corruption Day. Everybody is actually promising the Filipino people that they will stamp out corruption. Question, anong pagkakaiba ng gagawin nyo? Ito sa plano nila. Pareho din ba? Pangalawa, yung Marcos wealth, yung mga Marcoses, alam naman natin nagnakaroon dati, eh, nakalalaya na yun, wala na kulong, bilyon na sa kanila pa. Anong gagawin nyo sa kanila? And then third, si Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo, kung mapatunayan ang mga mayroong pagkakasala, anong posible nyo gawin? Anong magiging pagkakaiba nyo? Kasi parang pare-pareho lang.
Alam mo sa akin, malaki ang pagkakaiba. Bakit? Hindi ako napagkatiwalaan pa ng political power in my last 30 years of public existence. Pero student leader pa lang ako sa UP College of Law. Nagawa kong ipakulong ang ilang corrupt personalities sa lalawigan ng Bulacan. Ang tawag sa amin ay land grabbing syndicate leaders, two wealthy people, one judge, four lawyers. I was able to put them in prison. Because I gathered all the victims of land grabbing syndicate in different towns of Bulacan. I did not have any political power whatsoever. Now, with the presidential power, I studied the political and constitutional law of the Philippines before. The presidential power of the Philippine president is much greater than the power of the American president, technically speaking, because of one presidential decree of President Marcos, that the president of the Philippines has the power to intervene in the allocation of pork barrel or CDF or whatever you call it, allocated to different lawmakers, congressmen, and senators. And that's the reason why the check and balance in the Philippine democratic government is becoming a farce. Now, probably if I may share to you, one of the many offers to me by GMA government is to be the anti-corruption czar. He sent to our house Commodore Tirso Dangat, followed up by a multi-millionaire businessman in Makati. Why not accept to be the anti-corruption czar as being offered to you by GMA? And I told them in different places, he even followed up, Commodore Dangat even followed up in this office, aside from his visit in my house, with some witnesses. I told them, do you think this couple in Malacañang are serious in fighting corruption? If they are serious, do you think they will accept my simple requirement? What is your simple requirement? Full authority and full support. What do you mean? I should be allowed to overhaul and appoint key people in the commission on audit. I should be allowed to overhaul and appoint key people in ombudsman. I should be allowed and appoint key people in the Department of Justice, just three agencies. And I should be allowed to form a small composite army from armed forces of the Philippines, from the Philippine National Police, and from NBI. And I should be allowed to form different task forces as needed by situations, mainly composed of principal lawyers and principal certified public accountants. What will you do about these task forces? Task force number one, within 30 days, submit to this office everything about Piatco Terminal 3 scandal. Task force number two, within 30 days, submit to this office everything about fertilizer scandal. Task force number three, everything about Northern scandal, Southern scandal, communication scandal, so on and so forth. No sacred cows. Give me 6 months to 1 year. We will dismantle this corruption octopus in our government. No palakasa, no sacred cows. And I should be allowed to recommend just two undersecretaries in every major department. I don't need to appoint to recommend for cabinet members. Just two undersecretaries. What will you do?